Hi friends, on continuation of last session, that is P block element group number 13. In this session, we start with the chemical properties of group 13. So reactivity towards air. Boron is unreactive in crystalline form due to the presence of an oxide layer on the surfaces. Aluminium does not react with air at normal temperature, but high temperature they form oxides and nitrides. So basically general reaction, key reaction kya ho jayega aapke liye, 2e plus 3o2. 2e ki jagah pe aap balance karne ke liye 4e bhi le sakte ho, 2e2o3. Here in case 2e plus n2, 2en, that is e is equal to any element present into this group 13. The oxides of this boron, that is b2o3, is acidic. Oxides of aluminium and gallium are amphoteric in nature, and that of this indium and thallium are basic. तो यहाँ पे oxide का trend आपको पता चल जाना चाहिए. Initial means topmost family member acidic है, middle one family member जो है वो amphoteric है, and down to the group basic है. So trend किस हिसाब से है oxide का? When you come up to the down, atomic number increases, molar mass increases, size increases, basicity increases. Topmost is acidic in nature, downmost is basic in nature. Example, 4Al plus 3O2 gives 2Al2O3. Likewise, 2Al plus N2 gives 2AlN. एक और example आप boron के लिए भी लिख सकते हो. That is 4 boron plus 3O2 gives B2O3. Next, reactivity towards acid and alkali. Boron does not react with acid and alkali even at the moderate temperatures. But aluminium dissolved in mineral acid and aqueous alkali and thus shows amphoteric behavior. Now amphoteric, chapter number 9, yaad kijiye. The species can react with acid, react with base, that is entitled as amphoteric in nature. So here in case, boron does not react with acid and alkali, but aluminium can react with acid and alkali and converted into corresponding products. देखिए किस हिसाब से equation लिखना compulsory है वरना marks cut हो जाएगा. 2Al plus 6HCl they converted into 2AlCl3, that is dimerization, plus 3H2 is released. Second, 2Al plus 2NaOH plus 6H2O gives 2NaAlOH4 plus 3H2. So here in case you can say that aluminium react with HCl, that is an acid, and react with NaOH, that is base. So the species who react with acid and base both are entitled as amphoteric in nature. But it does not react with nitric acid due to the presence of this oxide layer on the surface. Perfect. तो वो ये एक चीज याद रखिएगा कि nitric acid के साथ वो chemical reactions नहीं करता है. Why? Just because the layer of oxide on a surface. Next, reaction towards halogen. They react with halogen to form trihalide. General example, 2E plus 3X2 you get 2EX3, that is trihalide, plus Al plus 3Cl2 gives 2AlCl3. This is a dimeric form. AlCl3 का dimer है ये. Al Cl3 1 2 and 3, while another Al 1 2 and 3. Now this Cl and this Cl are entitled as a bridge. They are the bridge between these two Al. So this is Al Cl Al. This Cl is in a bridge. Al Cl Al. This Cl is in a bridge. Fine. So this is all about your diagram. Diagram draw करना पड़ेगा whenever you discuss this. AlCl3 exists as a dimer. This is called dimer structure of AlCl3. Anhydrous aluminium chloride is partially hydrolyzed with moisture to liberate the fumes of HCl. So white fumes appear around the bottle of anhydrous AlCl3. The relative acidic strength of trihalide decreases like this. Bi3 greater than to this BBr3, BCl3, BF3. So this is all about your reactivity towards acid and alkali, followed by reactivity towards halogen. Next we moved on to this most important part, that is एनोमलस बिहेवियर ऑफ बोरोन एंड उसके बाद डिस्कस करेंगे डायगोनल रिलेशनशिप. एनोमलस बिहेवियर ऑफ बोरोन लाइक लिथियम एंड बेरिलियम. बोरोन द फर्स्ट मेंबर ऑफ दिस ग्रुप 13 ऑल्सो शो सम एनोमलस बिहेवियर. एनोमलस बिहेवियर किसकी वजह से होता है? दो मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चीज, स्मॉलर इन साइज, आयनाइजेशन एंड एन्थैल्पी. ड्यू टू द एक्सट्रीमली लो साइज एंड हाई न्यूक्लियर चार्ज बाय साइज रेशियो, हाई इलेक्ट्रॉन नेगेटिविटी, नॉन अवेबिलिटी ऑफ डी सबशेल एंड द मेन डिफरेंसेस आर एज फॉलोज. अब ये एक पॉइंट भी है, डी सबशेल नहीं है, रिमेनिंग फैमिली मेंबर के पास डी सबशेल है, तो एक्सपांशन कैन टेक्स प्लेस. बोरोन कैन नॉट एक्सपांड. व्हाई? जस्ट बिकॉज नो अवेबिलिटी ऑफ डी सबशेल. सो दिस आर द फ्यू रीजन एंड ड्यू टू दिस सम फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बोरोन इज डिफर फ्रॉम द रिमेनिंग फैमिली मेंबर. लेट्स स्टार्ट. बोरोन इज टिपिकल नॉन मेटल, वेयर एज रिमेनिंग अदर मेंबर आर मेटल इन नेचर. Boron is bad conductor of electricity, whereas other family member are good conductor of electricity. So first two point, first boron is typical non-metal, remaining family member are metal. Boron is bad conductor of electricity, whereas remaining are metal, so good conductor of electricity. Boron shows allotropy and exists in a two form, crystalline as well as amorphous, while in case of aluminium is a soft metal and does not exist in a different forms. Like other non-metals, the melting point and boiling point of boron are much higher than those of this another family member of group 13. Just because of smaller size, this thing is also there. Non-metal hai, so melting point and boiling point is species ka jyada hi hoga. Fifth, boron forms only covalent compound, whereas aluminium and another family member of group 13 even some ionic compound. The hydroxide and the oxides of boron are acidic in nature. Humne abhi discuss kiya, topmost is acidic, bottom one is basic in nature, where those the another are amphoteric and basic in nature. The trivalent boron exists as a monomer, but aluminium is dimer. स्ट्रक्चर प्रीवियस सेशन, इसी सेशन में आगे ही देखा, Al2Cl6 ब्रिज बॉन्ड, AlCl Al का ब्रिज बॉन्ड हमने डिस्कस किया, दैट इज कॉल्ड डाइमर. बोरोन एग्जिबिट द मैक्सिमम कोवेलेंसी इज 4, जस्ट बिकॉज अनअवेबिलिटी ऑफ डी सबशेल एक्सपांशन कैन नॉट टेक्स प्लेस एंड ड्यू टू दिस कोवेलेंसी इज ओनली 4, व्हाइल द अदर मेंबर ऑफ दिस कोवेलेंसी इज 6. देखिए AlOH6-3. Last two points, boron combined with the metal to give borides, that is Mg3B2. Other members form simple alloys. Simple alloy banayenge, but they react with another metal and convert into borides. Concentrated nitric acid oxidizes boron to convert into boric acid, but no such action notice in another group. Another family member ke upar HNOC ka koi effect dekhne ko nahi mil raha hai. Equation is B+3HNO3 gives H3BO3 +3NO2. So 10 anomalous behavior हमने देखा, approximately 8 minimum आपको याद रखने पड़ेंगे. Prepare टेनो के टेनो याद करने हैं, सभी के सभी fine. कई बार ये 3 mark में पूछा जाएगा तो कम से कम 6 से 8 लिखने पड़ेंगे. So this is all about your anomalous behavior. Next is all about diagonal relationship. Now diagonal relationship आप start किया था lithium से, lithium का diagonal था आपका Mg के साथ, then followed by आपने after lithium beryllium, beryllium का diagonal relationship था aluminium के साथ, and now it's time to discuss boron, boron का diagonal relationship है silicon के साथ. So, due to its small size, similar charge by mass ratio, boron differs from the other group number 13 member, that is anomalous behavior, but it resembles closely with the silicon. the second element of group number 14 to exhibit diagonal relationship. Some important similarities between boron and silicon are as follows. कुछ पांच या छह anomalous behavior आपने पढ़े, ऐसे ही कुछ पांच या छह diagonal relationship भी है, वो discussion करते हैं. Both boron and silicon are typical non-metals, having high melting point and boiling point near the same density, approximately same density, 2.35, while in case silicon having 2.34. Low atomic volume and bad conductor of current. However, both are used as a semiconductor. Both of them do not form cation and form only covalent compounds. Both exist and as a amorphous and crystalline state exhibit allotropy. Both possess a closer electron negativity values, that is 2.0 as well as 1.8. Both forms numerous volatile hydrides which spontaneously catch fires on exposure to this air, are easily hydrolyzed. So these are the few points. Fine. Last year really very important. The chlorides of both are liquid, fumes in most air and readily hydrolyzed by water. Example, BCl3 when treated with water you get BOH thrice plus fumes of HCl, white fumes, that is HCl ka fumes niklega. SiCl4 when treated with water you get SiOH4 plus 4HCl. Both forms of weak acids like H3BO3 and H2SiO3. Last is important one, the carbides of both boron and silicon are very hard and used as abrasive, that is B4C and SiC. These carbides are really very hard and used as abrasive, just like diamond. Fine, carbon jab padenge tab uske andar diamond padne wale, uske andar bhi hum use karenge this word. They are used as abrasive purposes, means cutting tools ke liye ye use hota hai. Glass ko cut karne ke liye bhi glass cutter ke aage ke part pe diamond lagaya hota hai. So last two points are important, that is anomalous behavior as well as diagonal relationship. So this is all about your today's session. Next session hum start karenge boron ke kuch important chemical constituents like borax, boric acid and diboron. So this is all about your today's session.